today we shall talk about next exam, more commonly known as National Exit Exam for MBBS. Let's understand it in a very simple way. Very important if you are a student of first, second or third year MBBS. Next exam would be mandatory or compulsory for students doing MBBS in India and students doing MBBS abroad and those who wish to practice in India. Next will be the single window examination, which will replace NEET PG exam. NEET PG exam, which is for PG admissions after completion of MBBS and internship. It will replace MCI screening, also called as the FMGE, Foreign Medical Graduate Exam. And it's for those students who are doing their MBBS from abroad. Both NEET PG and FMGE shall be dissolved and there will be single exam next. Next exam has been proposed by national body, that is NMC, National Medical Commission, and next will standardize the medical education in India. It will judge the conceptual understanding and problem solving skills of final year MBBS students. This exam will be implemented in 2022, so you have enough time to modify your study pattern to get real success in this exam. Exam pattern of next is very typical. It's divided into two parts. Next one is theory and next two is practical. Here is the pattern of next one, that is the theory. It's a 3-day examination. On every day, there is pre-lunch and post-lunch session. On day one, in pre-lunch session, there would be exam of 3 hours with 120 questions. These questions will be asked from medicine as a prime subject and dermatology and psychiatry as an allied subject. In post-lunch session, 60 questions from pediatrics will be asked. Duration will be 1.5 hours. So at the end of day 1, you have answered 180 questions. Day 2, pre-lunch, surgeries prime and orthopedics and anesthesia as allied subjects. Duration 3 hours with 120 questions to be answered. Post-lunch, 60 questions from ENT. Duration 1.5 hours. And for day 3, prime subjects, obstetrics and gynecology and radiology as an allied subject. Again, 120 questions to be answered in 3 hours. That's your pre-lunch session. In post-lunch session, 60 questions from ophthalmology. Again, duration is 1.5 hours. So overall, there would be 540 questions in 3 days. Total exam duration 14.5 hours. Now 10% of these MCQ questions from each stream will be on basic applied science, that is anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, microbiology and pharmacology. Other 10% questions will be from PSM. Now the type of questions asked in next exam will be absolutely different than the question asked in NEET PG or FMG exam. 60% of the questions of next exam will be based on problem solving. So it's like even if the book is given to you, answer of that question will not be there straight away. You'll be given some case and you have to give your diagnosis. 30% of the questions will be comprehension and analysis. So they might be like image-based questions or ECG strip might be given to you and you have to come up to some conclusion. Only 10% of the question will be of recall type, that is traditional standard MCQ questions where, say, investigation of choice of any specific disease is asked, something which is straightforward answer, one-liner answer. So you have now appeared for next one exam. Scoring will be based on percentile system. And once you pass next one, you proceed for your internship. 1 month after completion of your internship, there would be next two. Now this is practical examination. This exam would be conducted by your university. And you need to pass for your PG admission. Next two exam is just pass or fail. So its marks will not be counted for PG admission. Score of next one only be counted for PG admission. And this score will be valid for 2 years. In case if someone is not successful in next one exam, then he will not be allowed for internship. He has to appear again next year. As such, there is no limit on the reappearance. Now when you look at this pattern, it's something which cannot be mastered within a short time. You really need to study very systematically and properly with a rock solid foundation right from the beginning. Most of the competitive exams like USMLE, PLAB, IFORM are based on the concepts of conceptual understanding and problem solving. So in a way, it's a very positive step to prove yourself against someone scoring high simply by cramming the questions.